主题是信仰的勇士。
And this morning, our topic of our mutual study is the warriors of faith.
我们要来谈圣经里面旧约的一个人物。
And so, we would like to study on an Old Testament Bible character.
他的名字叫加勒。
And his name was Caleb.
这个人在圣经当中非常的出名。
And Caleb was a very famous person in the scriptures.
但事实上，对他的记载非常的少。
But the truth is that there is only a short record of his events.
我们想到了这一个人。
When we think of this character, Caleb,
第一个印象就是他非常的强壮。
First thing that we think of is that he was very strong.
很会打仗。
And he was a great warrior.
但是我们如果详细的查考圣经，
But if we study the Bible,
其实他真正的特点不是这个。
We'll see that this was not his most significant characteristics,
而是他在信仰上有非常杰出的表现。
But rather, his most important characteristic was that he was very fruitful and successful in his faith.
我们一起来看旧约圣经民数记第十三章。
Let us turn to Old Testament Scripture, Numbers chapter 13.
民数记第十三章。
Numbers chapter 13.
第一节到第三节
，verse 1 to verse 3。
民数记十三章第一节
，Numbers chapter 13 verse 1。
主晓谕摩西说：“你打发人去窥探我所赐给以色列人的迦南地，他们每个支派当中要打发一个人，都要做首领的。”第三节
，verse 3。
摩西就照着主的吩咐，从巴兰的旷野打发他们去。他们都是以色列人的族长，第四节之后记载这十二个人的名字。
And so from verse 4 onwards, it describes the names of these 12 that were sent.
在我们过去的印象里面
，and in our previous memory of this story,
我们认为这十二个人里面
We may have thought to ourselves that amongst these 12,
除了加勒跟约书亚以外的另外那十个人都非常的差。
The 10 besides Joshua and Caleb, we would have this preconceived notion that perhaps they were of bad character.
但事实上应该不是这样。
But the truth is far from it.
根据第一节到第三节的记载
，verse 1 to verse 3 tells us.
神吩咐摩西去挑选人。
The Lord spoke to Moses, sending him to pick out these 12.
在第二节里面说，必须要做首领的。
Verse 2 tells us that the criteria for Moses' choosing was that they need to be leaders amongst their tribe.
而第三节里面说，他们都是各支派的族长。
Verse 3 also tells us that they were the heads of the children of Israel.
如果根据出埃及记的记载
，And so according to the records of Exodus.
他们出埃及的时候
，When the Israelite people departed from Egypt,
二十岁以上能够当兵的，总共有600,000人。
Those who were above 20 years of age and were fit for the army or for battle had numbered 600,000.
现在他们要选多少人呢
？And so at this time, how many people did God ask Moses to choose?
12个人。
Only 12.
从600,000人里面选出12个人。
So amongst 600,000 people, Moses chose 12.
根据民数记里面记载各支派的人数。
And so according to numbers, we're recorded all the population of each tribe.
他每个支派都是几万人，甚至10,000-20,000人。
Each tribe numbered in the tens of thousands to the hundreds of thousands.
而在每一个支派里面只选一个人。
And amongst all these tribes, they only chose one out of each tribe.
你想这些人会很差吗
？So can we say that these people were of bad character?
神说必须要做首领的。
The Bible recorded that God said that these people have to be leaders.
而摩西去选的时候是每一个支派里面做族长的。
And Moses also chose the heads of the children of Israel.
如果按照比例来看。
And so, if we were to look at it from a purely from a ratio perspective,
这十二个人真的是精英当中的精英。
These 12 can be said to be the elite amongst the elite.
他们不可能是最差的一群。
These 12 were not of people of bad characteristics.
他 他们一定是最优秀的一群。
But they were the elite.
没有人能够比他们更优秀了。
There were none better than them.
所以事实上，这十二个人，包括那十个人，其实都是一时之选，是最为优秀的人才。
So the truth was that these 12 chosen, including the 10 aside from Joshua and Caleb, were all the elite amongst the elite.
所以他们才会赋予这样的任务跟重命，然后去做窥探的事情。
And only because of this were they entrusted with this heavy burden and this important duty of spying out the land.
在他们要出发之前，摩西吩咐了他们一些话。
Before they departed, Moses instructed them a few things.
我们来看第十七节，一直到二十节。
Let us read from verse 17 to verse 20.
民数记第十三章第十七节。
Numbers chapter 13, verse 17.
摩西打发他们去窥探迦南地，说：“你们从南地上山地去，看那个地如何，其中所住的民是强是弱，是多是少，所住之处是好是歹，所住之处是营盘是坚城，又看那个地是肥美是贫薄。”其中有树木没有，你们要放开胆量，把那地的果子带一些回来。那个时候正是葡萄成熟的时候。当摩西吩咐他们要出发，然后跟他们讲了一些话。
So when Moses sent them off, he gave them some instructions.
根据这段话里面的内容
，and according to the contents of Moses' instructions,
他们一方面要去看整个迦南地。的这个地理环境跟他们的自然生态。
On one hand, the people were to spy out and take a note of the geographic characteristics of the land of Canaan.
以及那一边的植物，那一边的物产。
And also their produce and their food.
另外一方面呢，还要去看那一边所居住的民族。
But they were also to spy out and take a note of the characteristics of the people that dwelt in the land of Canaan.
以及这些民族在那个地方的建设
，and also their infrastructure that was in the land of Canaan.
所以他们要观察的其实是全面性的。
And so these 12 were entrusted to make a holistic observation of the land of Canaan.
虽然在几百年前他们的祖先曾经住在那里
，although a few hundred years ago their ancestors were originally from the land.
但是现在来到这个地方的所有的以色列人，没有一个人去过这个迦南地。
But at this moment in time, none of the Israelite people have entered and seen for themselves the land of Canaan.
那么，当他们要进去的时候，他们需要全面的了解这个地方到底如何。
And so before they were to enter the land, they needed to have grasp a full understanding of the characteristics of the land.
而他们也真的。照着摩西所吩咐的去做了这一切的事情。
And so the 12 carried out this mission according to Moses had commanded them.
我们来看二十一节到二十四节。
Let's read from verse 21 to verse 24.
二十一节。
Verse 21.
他们上去窥探那个地，从寻的旷野到利禾，直到哈马口。他们从南地上去到了希伯伦，在那里有亚纳族人亚西曼是塞达买。原来希伯伦城被建造比埃及的所安城还要早七年。他们到了以斯各谷，在那里砍了葡萄树的一枝，上头有一挂葡萄。两个人用杠抬着，又带了一些石榴和无花果来。因为以色列人从那里砍来的那一挂葡萄，所以那个地方就叫以斯各谷。这里谈到了他们去到那一个地方。
And so here it talks about when the spies had entered into the land.
如果根据这一段的记载
，according to this particular the records of this particular passage，
其实他们是把迦南地给绕了一圈。
They had circled the entire land of Canaan one time。
而那个时候是葡萄成熟的时候。
And at that time was the season of the first ripe grapes。
所以他们也带葡萄回来了。
And so they also cut for themselves a branch of the vine to return with them。
我们再来看二十七节。
Let us continue to read verse 27,
一直到二十九节。
Let us read from verse 27 to verse 29.
又告诉摩西说：“我们到了你所打发我们去的那里，果然是牛奶与蜜之地，这就是那个地方的果子。然而 住在那个地的民强壮，诚意也坚固宽大，并且我们在那里看见了亚纳族人、亚玛利人住在南地，赫人、耶布斯人、亚摩利人住在山地，迦南人住在海边并约旦河边。他们去到迦南地之后，
So after they had spied out the land of Canaan，
他们真的照摩西所讲的去窥探那地的自然环境跟人文的建设。
As instructed by Moses, they gave a very good account of the geographical characteristics and also the cultural characteristics and the infrastructure that was in the land to back to Moses.
然后他们把水果带回来了，而且把那个地方观察得非常清楚。
So they also brought back along with them the fruit of the land, and they gave a good account of the situation of the land.
根据29节、28节之后的这种记载，
From the records of verse 28 onwards,
谁哪一个民族住在什么地方，他们有什么特色，其实他们调查的一清二楚。
We can see that these spies gave a very good account of which tribe lived where and what their situation was very clearly.
澳洲是一个很大的一个大陆。
And for example, Australia is a vast country.
这边有原住民居住在这个地方。
We have indigenous people that dwelt in this land.
也有很多外来的民族。
And we have also a lot of settlers who have come from abroad.
哪些族群会在那里，会在什么地方聚集？
And depending on your culture, you may have a likelihood to settle in a particular place.
而他们聚集的原因跟背景是什么？
And the reason why you would congregate in a particular city and the background that you have
其实这有一定的道理在里面，
is all related.
而他们现在去窥探迦南地的时候，
And so when the spies, similarly when the spies went out to spy out the land of Canaan,
哪一个民族住在什么地方？
Which tribe lived in what location?
山上的民族有他们的特色。
And what characteristics does the tribes that lived in the mountain have?
海边的民族有他们的特性。
The people that dwelt by the sea also have their own distinguishing characteristics.
他们的优劣点会因为自然环境所形成他们自己的传统跟特色。
Their advantages and their disadvantages and their cultures are all influenced by the places that they dwell, and they are all different from one another.
以色列人进来是要面对这些民族的。
And when the Israelite was to enter the land of Canaan, they will come up against
these people. 那个时代，他们一进来是要打仗的。
And when they come up against these people, what that means is that they will go to war.
他们一定要了解当地的情况。
And in order to go to war successfully, they need to have a good understanding of the characteristics and the geographical characteristics of each location and its people.
而且根据十三章整章的记载。
And so according to the records of the entirety of chapter 13,
这十二个人并没有分组，他们其实都是一起然后去窥探的。
When the 12 spied out the land, they did not divide themselves into smaller teams, but rather they did everything together as a 12.
然后到最后他们的结论出来了。
And in the end, they gave a summary.
我们来看32节。
Let us read verse
32. 一直到这一章结束。
Let us read from verse 32 until the end of the chapter.
探子当中有人论到所窥探之地，向以色列人报恶信说，我们所窥探经过的地方是吞吃居民之地，他们在那里所看见的人民都身量高大。我们在那里看见了亚纳族人，就是伟人，他们是伟人的后裔，根据我们看自己好像蚱蜢一样，根据他们看我们，我们也是如此。我们返回来看三十节。
Let us look back at verse 30 again.
三十节。
Verse 30.
加勒在摩西面前安抚百姓说，我们立刻上去得那个地，我们足能得胜。三十一节。
Verse 31.
但那些和他同去的人说，我不能上去攻击那个民，因为他们比我们强壮。他们窥探那个地回来之后，做了一些普遍的报告以后，他们下了一个结论。
And so after the spies had returned from their mission and gave a general account of what they had saw, they came to a conclusion for the people and Moses.
根据前面他们的报告，他们说那边真的是牛奶与蜜的地方，神这样讲真的是这个地方。
According to their report, they said that truly this is a land flowing with milk and honey, just as God had described.
虽然自然环境很好，物产非常丰富。
But although the land is very, very rich in produce,
但这是别人的地方。
But it belongs to others.
而且住在那里的居民比我们强壮。
And these others, these people that currently dwell in the land are stronger than we.
他们提到的一个民族叫亚纳族人。
They mentioned one type of people specifically called the Anaks.
这个民族住在希伯伦城。
And these people dwelt in the city of Hebron.
根据前面的记载。
And according to the records that we read previously.
在二十节里面说，希伯伦城很早就被建立起来了。
In verse 22, it describes that the city of Hebron was established very early on.
它比埃及的所安城早了七年就被建成了。
It predates the city of Zoan in Egypt by 7 years.
再加上这个民族身量非常的高大。
And not only so, the Anaks who dwelt there are great in stature.
因为中文的和本圣经是100年前翻译的。
So the Union version of the Chinese Bible was translated about 100 years ago.
在这个最后一节里面说伟人。
In the verse, in the last verse, it describes the Anak as great people.
其实就是所谓的巨人，也就是说身量非常高大的人。
But what it means is they are giants or people who are very tall in stature.
当以色列人看到这个民族的时候
，And so when the Israelites saw the men of this tribe,
他们在这里做了一个很强烈的一种比喻对比。
Here the spies made a very distinguishing comparison.
他说：“如果他们是人，那我们是蚱蜢。”
They said that we are like grasshoppers in their sight.
我们这样看他们，他们也一定会这样看我们。
Or we are grasshoppers in our own sight when we look at them, and they must view us in the same
way. 这是一个完全不成比例的一种对比啊。
In other words, that this comparison is of no contest.
那这样怎么打仗呢？
How can you fight against such a people?
而且这个城。这么早就建立起来了。
Not only so, this city is established, very well established for a long time.
可见他们有多进步。
And by this we can tell how advanced they must be in their technologies.
那我们怎么会赢呢？
How can we think to gain victory against such people?
所以他们的结论是说，这个地方非常好，但是我们不可能得得到。
And so the conclusions of the spy was that yes, it is indeed.A very prosperous land, but it is impossible for us to attain it.
但是很奇怪啊。
But very strangely,
第三十节有一个人讲了完全相反的结论。
In verse 30, we saw a person who gave a very different conclusion from the ten.
这个人是加勒。
This man was Caleb.
加勒讲的话，用中文圣经的语词来看。
And according to the words that Caleb spoke.
讲得非常非常坚决。
We can see that Caleb was a very determined person.
他说：“我们立刻去得那个地。”
He said, "Let us go up at once and take possession."
现在就去哦。
Let us go now.
我们现在就去得那个地。
We can take possession of it right now.
然后后面他说
，And then later he said,
我们一定会赢。
For we are well able to overcome it.
这是一个完全相反的结论呢。
And so this is a completely opposite conclusion to what the other spies had made.
别人看到了敌人。
When others saw foes.
别人看到了城。
When others saw great cities.
加勒没有看到。
Caleb did not put them in mind.
为什么结论是完全相反呢？
Why was he able to come to a separate conclusion?
大家都说不会赢。
A very different conclusion when others said that we will not win.
但加勒讲的是说一定会赢。
But Caleb said we are well able to do it.
而且我们现在就去。
So let us go now.
为什么会有这么强烈的一种结论出来
？How can the two conclusions be so drastically different?
如果你去看后面的这个圣经记载
，If you were to look at the later records of the Bible,
你会发觉加勒是一个非常会战争的人。
You will see that Caleb was a strategist, a good strategist, in battle.
而且他不是一个有勇无谋，只会用蛮力的那种人。
And so he does not rely only on pure force or brute force.
他跟约书亚一样，都是很有魔力，很知道怎么战争的人。
Just as Joshua, they were both very intelligent strategists when it comes to battle.
他们两个人既然能够当族长，能够在战场上成为勇士。
And since the two of them were able to be heads of the children of Israel and leaders of the tribe, they were great warriors in battle.
其实他们是非常有战争才能的人。
They were talented in military.Strategy.
所以他们一定会评估一切的事物，然后再做结论。
And so their conclusions are all made with much thought and calculation.
现在是大家看的结论是这样子。
And so even though others have made this conclusion,
为什么加勒看的同样的状况，他的结论是完全相反的？
Looking at the same situation, how come Caleb can come to a drastically opposite conclusion?
我们来看第十四章。
Let us continue to read chapter 14.
民数记第十四章。
Numbers chapter 14.
请看第六节一直到第十节。
Numbers chapter 14, verse 6 to verse 10.
民数记十四章第六节到第十节。
Numbers chapter 14, verse 6 to verse 10.
窥探那个地人当中，嫩的儿子约书亚和耶夫尼的儿子加勒撕裂的衣服，对以色列人全会众说：“我们所窥探经过之地是极美之地，神若喜悦我们，就必定将我们领进那个地，把地赐给我们。那个地原是牛奶与蜜之地，但你们不可背叛主，也不可怕那个地的居民，因为他们是我们的食物。”并且硬币他们的已经离开他们，有主与我们同在，不要怕他们。但是全会众说，拿石头打死他们二人。忽然主的荣光在会幕中向以色列人众人显现。当大家都说我们放弃吧，
When everybody says to give up,
我们不可能得到的，
When everybody says it is impossible for us to attain this land,
我们大家都回埃及吧，
Let us return back to Egypt.
加勒跟约书亚起来讲话。
Caleb and Joshua stood up and spoke to the people.
在这里其实是加勒起来讲话的。
And it was actually Caleb who addressed the people.
他在强调一次说，那个地方是牛奶与蜜，极美之地。
Once again, he reminded the people that the land was just as God has described it, that it is exceedingly good and flowing with milk and honey.
并且告诉大家说，我们不用怕那个地的居民。
And encouraged the people, saying that we do not need to fear the people of the land.
而他真正的理由是什么呢？
What was his reason for the people to not fear?
是第八节里面讲的。
Verse 8 tells us,
神若喜悦我们，
If the Lord delights in us,
一定会将我们带领到那个地，把那个地赐给我们。
And surely he will bring us into this land and give it to us.
神不喜悦他们吗？
Does God not delight in them?
当他们出埃及的那一刻
，The moment when they departed from Egypt，
神已经跟他们讲过了。
God already said to the people，
当摩西带他们出埃及的时候
，When Moses led them out of Egypt，
其实他们非常清楚他们要去哪里。
The people were clear on where their destination was at the end of this journey。
他们的目的地在哪里？其实他们非常知道。
They knew clearly what destination God had set for them。
为什么呢？
Why was that so?
因为神给他们应许嘛。
Because God made them a promise.
神告诉他们。
God said to the people,
我带你们出埃及。
I have led you out of Egypt.
要去到迦南美地。
To lead you into the land of Canaan.
要把那个地赐给你们。
And I will give you this land.
这是他们出埃及的时候神给他们的应许。
This was a promise that God made to the Israelite people when they left Egypt.
神答应要带他们进入那块地方。
God promised to lead them into the promised land.
今天他们已经来到那一块地的门口了。
And today they are at the doorsteps of this promised land.
为什么加勒说我们立刻上去，我们一定会赢？
Why did Caleb have this faith to speak such words that let us go now, we will surely overcome them?
因为神答应的。
It is because he knew that God had promised them this.
因为这是神说的。
Because it is something that God has personally spoke.
在我们出发的那一刻。
That at the moment when we got up and left.
神已经告诉我们要把那块地赐给我们了。
God had already told us that he will give the land to us.
的确有很多困难。
Yes, there may be obstacles.
敌人的确非常强大。
Yes, the enemies may appear great and numerous.
我们的挑战可能真的超过我们的能力。
And perhaps the challenge and the task at hand is truly beyond our abilities.
所有的这一切都是事实。
All this may be facts.
但是这一些会比神的应许更强烈吗？
But can these facts overcome the promise of God?
这一些会超越过神的应许吗？
Can these factors exceed the promise of God?
难道神会骗我们吗？
Will God lie to us?
难道神会带我们到了这个地方，然后放弃我们吗？
Will God lead us to the doorsteps of this land only to desert us?
为什么加勒能够这么坚持呢？
Why was Caleb able to have such determination?
为什么加勒的结论是跟别人都不一样的呢？
Why was Caleb able to come to a conclusion that was drastically different from everybody else?
所有的事实跟困难摆在面前。
When all the facts and difficulties are laid out before him,
他都看到了。
He has seen it clearly.
但是他抓住了神的应许。
But what he was able to do was hold on to the promise of God.
因为是神说的。
Because God has said so.
是神答应的。
Because God has promised us so.
是神要带我们进去的。
That God himself will lead us into this land.
既然如此。
If this is the case.
神走在前面。
God is walking before us.
我们跟随神的脚步。
We are merely following in God's footsteps.
我们一定有办法超越这个困难。
We will surely be able to overcome all these difficulties.
所以加勒之所以说我们立刻上去一定会赢。
And so when Caleb said, "Let us go now, we will surely attain this land."
不是盲目的，不是没有理由的。
He did not say this out of no reason and out of blindness.
也不是说。他完全不看事实，然后把这所有的一切都忽略掉。
And he was also not being blind to the reality of what difficulties laid ahead.
因为他抓住了一个更高的应许。
But he was able to overcome these facts that are before his eyes because he was able to grasp onto a higher promise.
我们来看十四章二十四节。
Let us read chapter 14, verse 20.
民数记第十四章二十四节。
Numbers chapter 14, verse 20.
唯独我的仆人加勒，因为他另有一个心志，专一跟从我，我就把他领进他所去的那一个地，他的后裔也必定会得那一地为业。这是神说的话。
And so here are the words of God.
当事情过去了之后。
After all this.
神出现讲话。
God appeared and spoke.
在这里，神肯定了加勒。
And here, God affirmed Caleb.
他说加勒有另外一个心志，这个所谓的另外一个心志就是专一跟从神。
And he vindicated Caleb by saying that he has a different spirit in him from the rest of the people, and that was that he followed God fully.
当其他人被这些困难击倒而放弃了。这一条路的时候
，When others are overcame by the difficulties that laid ahead of them and gave up the promise of God，
忘记了他们出埃及的时候，神给他们应许所讲的话的时候
，They forgot God and they also had forgotten the words that God spoke to them when they got up and left Egypt。
加勒抓住了神的应许。
Caleb was able to still hang on to the promise of God，
跟从主
，and he followed God fully，
而且。从不改变
，and he never wavered，
就是因为对主的应许有这样的信心
，and it is because he had such faith towards the promise of God，
所以他才能够坚持到底
，that he was able to persist and persevere to the end，
他才能够看到别人所没有看到
，that he was able to see with his own eyes what others could not，
所以他的信心是有根据的。不是胡来的，也不是盲目的。
And so his faith was based on facts rather than being brash and blind.
从这里我们看到加勒在信仰上杰出的表现。
So from here we can see that Caleb was a warrior, not just in battle but in faith.
所以加勒不但是战场上的勇士而已，他更是 信仰上的勇士。
And so he was valiant in his actions.
这样的信仰坚持多久呢？
And so how long did he keep such a faith for?
我们来看约书亚记。
Let us turn to the book of Joshua.
约书亚记十四章。
Joshua chapter 14.
约书亚记第十四章
Joshua chapter 14,
第六节一直到十五节
Let us read from verse 6 to verse 15.
约书亚记十四章第六节
Joshua chapter 6 verse, Joshua chapter 14 verse 6.
那个时候犹大人来到基甲见约书亚有基尼西族耶夫尼的儿子加勒对约书亚说主在加底斯巴尼亚指着我跟你对神人摩西所说的话你都知道了第七节
Verse 7
主的仆人摩西从加底斯巴尼亚打发我窥探这个地那个时候我正好四十岁我按着心意回报他第八节
Verse 8
然而同我上去的众弟兄使百姓的心都消化了但我专心跟从主我的神第九节
Verse 9
当那一日摩西启示说你脚所踏之地必定要归你和你的子孙永远为业因为你专心跟从主我的神第十节
Verse 10
自从主对摩西说这话的时候主就照着他所应许的使我存活这四十五年期间以色列人在旷野行走看啊今天我已经八十五岁了第十一节
Verse 11
我还是强壮像摩西打发我去的那一天一样无论是征战出入我的力量那时如何现在还是如何十二节
Verse 12
求你将主那一日应许我的这个山地给我那里有亚纳族人并宽大坚固的城你也曾听见了或者主照着他所应许的与我同在我就把他们赶出去第十三节
Verse 13
于是约书亚为耶夫尼的儿子加勒祝福将希伯伦给他为业十四节
Verse 14
所以希伯伦做了基尼西族耶夫尼的儿子加勒的产业一直到今天因为他专心跟从主以色列人的神十五节
Verse 15
希伯伦从前的名字叫基列亚巴亚巴是亚纳族人中最尊大的人于是国中太平没有战争民数记十三十四章是他们刚出埃及的时候
Numbers chapter 13 and 14 records the events that happened when not long after they had departed from Egypt
我们现在所看到的约书亚记十四章
And so now as we read Joshua chapter 14
已经四十五年过去了
It is 45 years later
他们已经进入迦南地一段时间了
Now they have entered into the land of Canaan for some time
这个时候加勒来见约书亚
And at this time Caleb came and saw Joshua
他对约书亚说我要那一块地
And he said to Joshua I want this land
他所谓的那一块地就是希伯伦
And the land that he referred to is Hebron
他说四十五年前神答应要给我
And he said to Joshua 45 years ago God had promised me this land
所以今天请你把那一块地赏赐给我
And so now please grant me this land
我们在读这段经文的时候
When we read this passage,
我们常常会读第十节跟十一节
Quite often we focus on verse 10 and verse 11
好像这是这一段经文的重点
As if this was the focus of this passage
因为这里说他八十五岁了
Because here Caleb said that he was 85 years old
他说他还是强壮像四十岁的时候一样
He said he was just as strong as he was when he was 40
他说那个时候如何现在也是如何
And he said as I am then I am now
我不知道加勒讲这话是真的还是假的
And I don't know if it was actually true physically what Caleb said
如果是真的
If it was true in fact if it was in fact true
那真的是一个天大的福气、啊、
Then it is indeed a great blessing from God
一个人四十岁跟八十五岁他的体力身体状况完全一样
For a person to be of the same strength and energy when he is 85 and when he is 40.
这真的是很难得。
It's something that is difficult to achieve.
我在去年底退休。
Last year, at the end of last year, I retired.
不知不觉发觉我已经变成老人了。
And I discovered that unknowingly and gradually I have become an old man.
当我看到黄共会的时候
，and when I saw brother Joseph Huang，
我就想起我20岁的时候
，I remember when I was 20 years old。
那时候我是他宗教教育老师
，I was his RE teacher。
我那个时候多年轻啊
！How young was I back then？
体力多好啊
！How energetic was I back then？
现在当然不能跟那个时候比啊
！But now I cannot compare myself to those days。
加勒能够得到这种福气，这不是每一个人都得到的啦。
And for Caleb to have such blessings is not something that everybody can obtain。
但是这一段经文的重点不在这里。
But I think the emphasis and the main point of this passage is not this。
这段经文不是要说加勒的身体多壮。
This passage is not trying to tell us how blessed Caleb was because he was still so strong at the age of 85。
这一段经文是要说加勒的信心有多好。
But what this passage wants to tell us is how great and how strong Caleb's faith is.
45年过去了。
And still is after 45 years.
加勒没有忘记神的应许呢。
After 45 years, Caleb has still not forgotten God's promise to him.
出埃及。
When he left Egypt,
神说要把迦南地给他们。
God said that he will give them the land of Canaan.
在45年前，他坚持这个应许。
45 years ago, he upheld this promise before the people.
45年过去了。
45 years later,
这个时候他来见耶稣亚。
At this moment in time, he came to see Joshua.
他还抓住了神的应许哦。
He was still holding on to this promise.
因为民数记13章的事件以后。
Because of the events, because after the events of Numbers chapter 13.
我们刚刚读民数记14章的时候，神也这样应许他。
In Numbers chapter 14, we also saw that God had promised Caleb.
你脚所踏过的地方，我要赐给你。
The land that which your feet has stood on and I've walked on, I will give it to you.
他知道是哪一块地。
And he knew which land God was referring.
他来见约书亚。
And when he saw, came to see Joseph.
他说当初神讲的话。
And he said to Joshua the words that God has spoke.
摩西听到了。
In the past that Moses had heard.
你也听到了。
And you have heard it.
我也听到了。
And I have heard it.
45年过去了。
45 years later.
今天，请你把那一块地给我。
Today, please give me this land.
因为这是神答应我的。
Because this is the land that God has promised me.
45年。
45 years.
他没有忘记，也没有改变。
Did not forget, and he did not waver.
他还抓住了神的应许。
He was still holding onto the promise of God.
既然神说那块地要给我
，And since God has promised to give me this piece of land，
那我一定得到那块地
，And surely I will able to obtain it。
而且我一定要得到那块
，And I will surely obtain it。
所以他来找约书亚
，And so he came to see Joshua。
我们在13节之后
，And from verse 13 onwards，
我们看见约书亚就说：“好啊，那就把这块地给你啊。
”We saw that Joshua granted him his request and said, "Yes, have this land."
约书亚做得很干脆啊。
Joshua was very, very decisive.
好像约书亚就也把一切承诺全部都实现了。
It is as if Joshua was very decisive in fulfilling, in agreeing and fulfilling the promise that God has given.
但事实上根本不是这样。
But the truth is, it is not that simple.
因为当加勒来见约书亚的时候
，Because when Caleb came to see Joshua.
希伯伦根本还没攻下来。
Hebron was still not yet captured by the Israelites.
亚纳族人还住在里面呢。
The tribe of Anak, the people of Anak, were still.
所以耶稣要说这块地给你，这个城给你。
And so when Joshua said to Caleb, "You may have this land, you may have the city."
他的意思是什么
？What does Joshua mean?
你自己去攻啊。
Joshua, in other words, is saying to Caleb,
你打得下来就是你的。
Go and capture it for yourself if you can.Capture the city, then it is yours.
结果加勒真的去把这个城攻下来。
And truly, Caleb went and captured this city.
我们来看15章。
Let us read chapter 15.
13节。
Verse 13.
到14节。
To verse 14.
约书亚记15章13节。
Caleb, Joshua chapter 15, verse 13 to verse 14.
约书亚照着主所吩咐的，将犹太人当中的一贯地，就是基列亚巴，分给耶户尼的儿子加勒。亚巴是亚纳族的始祖，基列亚巴就是希伯伦。加勒就从那里赶出了亚纳族的三个族长，就是示塞、亚西曼、达马。你要这块地很好啊，你拿去啊。
So Joshua said to Caleb, "If you want this land very well, take it."
但到最后呢，你自己去打。
But you will need to capture it for yourself.
我们回想民数记发生了什么事、啊、
？So now let us think back what happened in Numbers.
为什么以色列人说我们要回家，我们不去迦南地了
？In the book of Numbers, why did the Israelites say, "We do not no longer want to enter the land"?
真正让他们退后的是哪一个民族
？We want to go back to Egypt. Who were the people that struck such fear into the Israelites?
是亚纳族人。
It was the Anaks.
而现在亚纳族人还住在希伯伦里面。
And now the Anaks still lived in the city of Hebron.
加勒坚持了45年。
And after 45 years of persisting,
今天他同样面对了这些巨人跟这个坚固的城。
Caleb, now 45 years later, is still faced with the challenge of overcoming these giants, these people of great stature.
难道那个困难结束了吗？
So,
难道敌人不见了吗？
So the difficulty has not changed. The enemy was still there.
没有啊，还在那里啊。
Yeah, so nothing has changed.
但是加勒赢了。
But 45 years later, Caleb was able to gain victory.
把这个城给攻下来了。
Able to capture the city.
为什么呢？
Why was he able to do so?
他会打仗吗？
Is it because he was skilled in battle?
他是战场上勇士吗？
Is it because he was a warrior on the battlefield?
他所抓住的其实不是这个。
But what he upheld was not these skills.
他抓住的是神的应许。
What he was able to grasp hold of was the promise of God.
神说要给我。
God has promised me this.
神一定会给我。
Then surely God will give it into my hands.
神答应我的，他绝对不会改变。
What God has promised will never be altered.
所以这个时刻，他真正得到神的应许。
It is at this moment that he was truly able to gain and obtain for himself the promise that God had promised him all those years ago.
一个人能够将信心坚持这么久。
For a person to hold on to his faith for such a long time,
真的是很不简单。
It is really something that is difficult.
我们在信仰的过程里面
，in our journey of faith,
总有高峰也有低峰，会起起落落的。
There are times that when we are at the peaks of our faith, but there are also sometimes when we are at our lowest points in faith.
我想这是很正常的。
This is all normal.
但是软弱了没有关系。
It is okay to become weak.
重点是坚持。
But the key is whether or not we persist.
坚持走下去。
Whether or not we persevere until the end.
坚持跟随主。
Whether or not we persevere in following the Lord.
为什么我们能够这样
？How are we able to persevere?
永不忘记神的应许。
We are able to persevere by never forgetting and letting go of the promise of God.
所以加勒不只是战场上的勇士。
And so Caleb was not only a warrior in battle.
他真的是一位信仰上的勇士。
He was truly also a warrior of faith.
他的坚持。
His perseverance.
他抓住神的应许。
His ability to grasp hold onto the promise of God.
他几十年不改变的信心。
And his unwavering faith over many decades.
真的很值得我们学习。
Is something that is worthy of our imitation.
我们中间有第一代来到布里斯本这些地方的弟兄姐妹。
Amongst our brothers and sisters, there are some of us who are first generations arrivals in Brisbane.
当我们今天还坐在会堂里面参与安息日崇拜的时候
，And when we are still able to sit in this chapel today to observe the Sabbath day service.
一方面，我们感谢神的带领跟保守。
On one hand, we thank God for His guidance and preservance.
一方面，我也真的很钦佩各位在几十年当中坚持走在主的路上。
But on the other hand, I am also very thankful and admonished by your ability to persevere in throughout many decades to continue to walk on the path of the Lord.
圣经里面有这样的人物作为我们学习的榜样。
In the Bible, there are also such characters who have set the example for us.
我们把这样的人物放在我们的生活当中。
We are able to remember these characters in our daily lives.
用这个来激励我们，来勉励我们，来坚固我们。
And use them as our source of encouragement and our source of strength.
相信我们信仰人生的路必定会得到主的带领。
And surely, in our journey of faith and journey throughout life, God will surely guide us.
无论什么时候，无论在什么地方。
No matter what the time is and what the place.
当我们坚持走在主的路上，我们就会得到主的带领。
So long as we persevere to walk in the way of the Lord, then the Lord Himself will guide us.
当我们始终抓住神的应许，我们就能够坚持到底。
We are able to continually grasp onto the promise of God, then we can persevere to the end.
唱诗。
Let us sing hymn.